When you build a social media app, you will need a following system. Today I will explain how you can set following system in Flutterflow. We will begin with Firebase structure. We will open Firestore documents. We must define a following list which will reference two users. So choose a name for this list and click select data type. We will choose is list because we must collect all followers in array which will be defined to authenticate user. After that, click document reference and choose users. Well, we finished our Firebase structure. Now, time to set button for following system. We must create a page parameters. This will bring other users' documents because we will need other users' reference ID. Now we will add action to buttons. We will start with follow button. Click add action and search update document. Choose authenticate user record reference. Find following data name and list update type will be add to set. Choose user document which will provide it by page parameters and choose reference. We will also add another action to chain which is refresh database request. Choose the widget which you put your button. Okay, we set follow button. Now we will define unfollow button. We will follow same path, but we will just change list update type as remove from set. Now we should hide one button which will be depend on following list. When user click to follow button, they should see unfollow button and shouldn't see follow button at the same time. We will use conditional visibility. Choose conditional and single condition. First value will be authenticate users and following list. Available options will be list contain item. Choose user documents. Reference. Okay, now it must be equal to and second value set as specific value and false. We will follow same path for unfollow button. We'll just play with seconds value. Specific value will be true. And we finished all actions. We built button system and now time to build followers and following pages. I will start with followers page. We will start with page parameters and it will be same like we did this before. We will call users documents. So we will add backend query. Choose your user collection. And query type will be list of document. We will filter our query with following list. Relation will be array contained. After that, we will choose authenticate user record reference. We finished our backend query. Now set username, full name, and profile picture. I will show one of them. And others will be same like what I do. I will show you username settings. Choose user documents and username. Others will be same like this. Now, time to set buttons again. I will not describe because it is the same what we did before. I will just show you again how you will set them. It's finished. Now time to build following page. First of all, we must generate dynamic children on list view. Give it a name for variable. After that, choose authenticate users following list. Okay, we generated dynamic children. We will add backend query now. We will choose user collection and query type will be single document and confirm query. We will call users documents now. We will add backend query again. We will choose our row and add backend query. Query type will be document from reference. Set variable will be our dynamic children. And it is finished. We will set users information and buttons again like we did before. I am showing you now. Now, I would like to show you how you can show following and followers numbers we have. Go to your profile page and choose your following number text. Click authenticate user, following list. Available option will be number of items and number format. Confirm it. Let's build followers number. Choose your follower number text. Add backend query, choose user collection, list of documents. We will filter query now. Collection field name will be following, relation will be array contains, value will be authenticate users, user record reference. Confirm it. Now click to text, choose user documents. Available options will be number of items. Available options will be number format. That's it. Well, everything is ready for our following system. Now time to test our system. Okay, let's check if it works or not. As you can see, we don't follow anyone and we have 5 followers. Now I will go to my feed. See, there is some accounts. This is our follow button. Click. And click. And well, I follow 2 accounts now. I will add another. As you can see, it's changed. We have 3 following. And let's check. And it is working. If I say unfollow, it's gone. Unfollow. Well, I will show my followers. I did them before because I don't want to lose your time, spend your time. I check. I follow them now. Well, it is working, as you can see. We finished another Flutterflow video. If you like this video, please click the like button. I will continue to share new videos about Flutterflow once a week, so you can subscribe to my channel and you will know when it's published. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.